It's a great opportunity for all of us to brainstorm about all aspects of education. In fact, when we talk about all aspects of education, obviously the attention gets divided, there are various segments of it, it's a pyramid. So we need to think about all aspects of it, we need to think about even each aspect of it. When we say all aspects of it, then we probably do not discuss each. And if we start discussing only small, we may forget the main big picture. So it's very important that we really need to look at all issues. Education is obviously the most important part, which is the height of the pyramid, obviously the size is smaller. But unless we have the bottom of the pyramid, which is extremely well taken care of, then probably the top of the pyramid may not get the best that we want. So therefore, we must not lose sight of this fact that we need to focus on each aspect of it. And when we talk about education, I think we really need to do a lot. First of all, as we always believe in, there are several education experts have highlighted this point, is there nothing like static education. You cannot say that I have learned and now I have learned enough, so there is no need for me to learn anymore. Someone who says that, then probably the most uneducated person. But he ceases to learn, and learning is a continuous process. He's obviously setting his thinking out, and therefore he's going to be a big loser. Now, when we want to do this constant learning, I think that's something which, I think one element of that, how do you integrate that and mainstream that into this economy of higher education is something which we really have to think very carefully. I'm a chartered accountant. So when I studied chartered accountancy, I was feeling very, very proud that I am a chartered accountant. Till I met someone younger than me, he said, you are only a chartered accountant. I am a cost accountant as well as company secretary. Till I met someone that was impressed with him, till someone I met, he said, actually this guy is not as educated. He has done only this CS, company secretary, and CN, CA, cost accountant. I am also an MBA. And then someone I met, he said, only an MBA, I have done my PhD in master education. So I think this is something which we must keep in mind, that there is always a room for doing better, and that's something which is not just acquiring qualification. I cannot say I am more educated because I have more qualification just down my name. That doesn't mean anything really. In terms of usability of that knowledge in a given situation, in a changing environment, is something which is going to be extremely critical. Like I know the technology. If someone says that we have done a great job, we have developed a fantastic product, and now this product is so good that I can go and relax. So obviously we relax the rest of his life because there is no business to be done. Like one of the great companies, if you remember, I mean when we were growing up, if you want to do anybody's picture, even today, now they have all the people are taking pictures without any film power. Kodak was a great company in the world. And there was no competition in Kodak. So therefore they thought there is no competition, why we should worry? But obviously now Kodak has to do something which is best suited for them, relax. So therefore, unless you actually think about constantly upgrading yourself, not only in terms of acquiring degrees, but the knowledge now is not just going to come into the classrooms. The knowledge is something which is going to be seen at a marketplace also. Something which is going to change, the marketplace is changing so rapidly. So what is changing at marketplace is not just management technique which you can learn in one of the IIMs or in Harvard or somewhere else. But what is important is also the application of technology into marketplace, which is changing the entire rules of business. And therefore, how do you actually acquire that is also going to be extremely important. But as I said, I am the misfit. You are all experts. You will deliberate and debate on it adequately. So I don't want to be intervention which does not mean anything except some more time that could have been devoted for something more productivity. So wishing all the best to you. I hope this second education education summit will take us to the higher level of thinking. I think education is one part, enlightenment is something different. And not necessarily always you get enlightenment from education. In fact, we have seen some of the most uneducated people were probably the one of the most enlightened people. And so therefore, again, something which I don't want to say it here, but one of the most uneducated people, dropouts from schools, are the richest people in the world. So this is something again, the relationship between Lakshmi and Saraswati cannot be very well established. The relationship necessarily between enlightenment, which was attained by so many top scholars, and not necessarily education. So what is necessary therefore, is there is no argument against education. This is in fact an argument in favor of how can education capture enlightenment, how can education lead us to becoming, acquiring more wealth, and that is what is necessary, and that's what I hope will be the purpose of this second education. Thank you very much.